PowerDirector has failed me. PowerDirector does not complete the upload. What do we do? And this does happen sometimes. Sometimes it does. Now, I really advise that you save all your work before you start rendering, just in case you do lose something, and you should save periodically. But when we actually go to produce, we're going to notice two things that happen here when you're actually uploading. When you're presented with this screen, you'll notice down here where it says export folder, I'm telling it where to put the video. Super, super important. You're going to click the gear here at the very top. You're going to go to File, and you'll see here where it says Export Videos, you can actually put where you want it to export to. Now that's important. It's important that you know where you're exporting the videos to. Now the reason for that is, once you select whatever settings, and we're going to say upload it to YouTube, you'll notice that we're going to be presented with two bars here. The one bar is going to produce the movie. The other bar is going to upload the movie. And sometimes PowerDirector will fail when it finishes the second bar. Well, when it's done producing, if you know where that file was created, then you can go to YouTube and just upload it manually by clicking the upload button on YouTube. It really doesn't matter about this here. This just makes it more convenient. That's all it does. Nothing more. So, if you've actually produced all the way through, but the upload has failed, we'll just go to YouTube and upload it manually and go to the folder where the actual video is. And you will see how easy that is. But this is important to know where you've exported it to, or else you're not going to know where to get it to upload it. If you've enjoyed learning about PowerDirector, you may wish to subscribe below. You may also wish to watch the video that's in this video. At any rate, guys, I'll catch you on the next one.